Do you have that?
Grayson, did you connect?
Your voice. Instead of talking, you choke up like you're going to cry all the time, just to relieve the pressure of the things that you cannot say. You don't even remember why it is that you cannot say them. You tell yourself they were stupid, but they probably would have revealed you as the fool that you are. Unfit for human conversation, unfit for human understanding, unfit for human anything. So, better to be silent. Better to stick your head in an oven or in a bowl of water, breathe in water instead of air. Just fill yourself with something different. Gas, feathers, anything to fill this awful empty. Anything. Oh, no, 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 Mrs. Carnegie. No. I'm all right. I'm not threatened or danger or in any harm of any kind, but the thing is, Mrs. Carnahan, I will not be opening the door. Mostly because there is no reason to, but also because I am with a lover. That's right, I am with a beautiful man! And he gives my life meaning, and we are without clothes! And that's right, we are fresh and scented and from the act of love! The door, Mrs. Carnahan, well, that would be an embarrassment for you, and we would be judging. You see, the spell would be broken. And then after you became pleasant with my condition and you left, my lover would dress and kiss me somewhat impersonally and then exit the room with the faintest click. And then I would be alone, Mrs. Carnahan. At a time where being alone is very worrisome because, you know, the things that give your life meaning are getting harder and harder to come by, and I really don't want to be alone, Mrs. Carnahan. I really don't. Hello? Mrs. Carnahan? Oh, thank God. Thank you.
Union dues? No! You signed the contract. with my dad and a handful of babes. The end. Ding, 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 ding.
Thank you. Tara Lloyd. I'm Hamza Manat.
I'm Anna May, and we are proudly representing Troop 3352 as we present Words, Words, Words by David Ives.
I don't know.
Quiet, please. I'm trying to concentrate here.
Okay, so what have you got? Ping, Draba, Inglewood, Carcinoma.
I like the...
Yeah, I don't want to pee it.
But do you think it's Hamlet?
Don't ask me, I'm just a gem.
Well, they could have given us a clue or something.
But that defeats the whole purpose of the experiment.
Three monkeys typing into infinity will sooner or later produce Hamlet.
Right.
Completely by chance.
And Dr. David Rosenbaum, up in that booth, is gonna prove it.
But what is Hamlet?
I don't know.
What is Hamlet?
I don't know.
You know what? This is really stupid! Postmodernism?
20 lines of that and I went dry. I got blocked. I felt like I was repeating myself.
But do you think that's in Hamlet?
I don't get what I'm doing here in the first place. I'm not a writer. I'm a monkey. I'm supposed to be swinging on branches and digging up ants, not sitting under fluorescent lights 10 hours a day.
But what if one of us does write Hamlet?
Will we really be released?
Will they give us the key to this?
Hemorrhoid.
Enter Bernardo and and Francisco.
Pomegranate.
Bernardo says, who's there?
Bazooka!
Thank you. Hello, my name is Grayson Schreiber, and I proudly represent Clear Creek High School in Troop 3352. Today I'll be performing Giants in the Sky from Into the Woods. There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, towerable giants in the sky. When you wake up behind, you look below at the world you've left and the things you know. The glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you wake up behind, you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known. The sky is land, the earth is stone. You're free to do whatever pleases you. Explore things you never get, cause you don't care what's in the desert. Big, tall, towerable giant at the door. Tall, towerable lady giant sweeping the floor. And she gives you food and she gives you press. And she draws you close to her giant breast. And you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just you've made a friend and all. You know she's big and she don't feel small. Someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you long for the things you've known, the world you've left and the little you own. The fun is done, you steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and keep below, and the world you know begins to grow. The house and your mother at the door. Roof, the house, and a world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. You're back again, only different than before. After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, towerable, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky!
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Julius Bob. We're proudly representing Troop 3352, and I'm performing a monologue from God Said This by Landon Aqua Winkler and Don Trail Who Kissed the Sea by Nathan Allen Davis. Thank you.
Hi.
Y'all know my name.
I'm James.
I am an alcoholic. What I've been thinking about is women. Yeah, there was a time where every woman in my life was hard on me. Not my wife, my mother, my daughters, the eldest especially. Yeah, she never came around that one. Even when I was sick, she didn't come around. But now that my wife, now that she's sick, she's back, at least for the next few days, to be with her at the hospital. So, all the women in my life are back together again. Well, minus my mother, may she rest in hell. But it's making me wanna drink. I like to run away from my problems before I was sober, but now, feel everything. My wife's sickness, I feel that. The eldest daughter's hate, feel that too. And well,
For the younger one, I feel it looking at me sometimes. With this sympathy. And that gets to me more, you know. I don't need anybody to feel bad for me.
That's what I've been thinking about. So I'll let y'all know.
You were probably going to remember this, but I was 5, so D was 4, and we're playing, and all of a sudden he leans over to me all secretive, and he's like, I'm going to the zoo tomorrow. And I'm like, cool, we going to the zoo tomorrow, because, you know, I like to miss events. I come over here in the morning, your mom answers the door, and she calls for D. He doesn't come. I'm like, he's not still sleeping, is he? We got to get to the zoo. And she looks at me like, zoo? Walk back to D's room, bounce. For real, he got up all early, actually going the right direction too, crazy thing is. Because when the cops finally found him, he's like on the route. Now, I just remember standing here, terrified. Now, because to me, the most dangerous part about going to the zoo without an adult is that one of the animals would eat you. So I got these visions of D like trying to buy a hot dog, and then a bear just comes and tackles him. And it's over. Then, your mom opens the door. She got D in her arms, and he's all grown man angry, you know what I'm saying? Your mom's crying and crying. All I could think of was Dontrell's invincible. Now he fought that bear. Mm-hmm. And he won. Thank you.
Julius Bob actually got a superior performance in our one act that we took to state for the Yellow Wallpaper. So he actually got a superior as well in that performance.
Hello, my name is Adriana Sweet. I've Miss Ackbach, come on. This is their director. She does, this is what, your fourth year there? And she's done an amazing job. So thank y'all. Thank you.